Hello friends, good morning. Welcome to our zoology class. In our previous class, we have discussed about the phylum, Porifera, Cnidaria and Platyhelminthes. Today, in this session, we are going to discuss about the phylum Nematoda and its classification. Okay, let us start. See, the term Nematoda was coined by the scientist Gagan Bohr. The term Nematoda was coined by Gagan Bohr. Okay, the phylum Nematoda includes roundworms or threadworms. Unique feature of phylum Nematoda is presence of collagenous cuticle. Means cuticle which is made up of collagen. So, unique feature of phylum Nematoda is collagenous cuticle. Okay, next. The muscles present in the phylum Nematoda are only longitudinal muscles. So, in phylum Nematoda, circular muscles are absent. Only longitudinal muscles are present. Next, excretion. So, in phylum Nematoda, excretion is performed by gland-like structures called renit gland and canals. So, excretion is performed by gland-like structures called renit gland and canals. Next, we had to know about these two terms. Amphids and phasmids. Amphids means, of course, these are anterior chemoreceptors. Anterior chemoreceptors. Whereas the phasmids are posterior. Amphids means A, anterior. Phasmids, P, posterior. These are chemoreceptors. These are glandulosensory receptors. Okay? Yeah. Let us start the classification of phylum Nematoda. This phylum Nematoda is classified into two classes, okay? That is Aphasmidea and Phasmidea, okay? Aphasmidea, it's called Adenophoria, okay? Adenophoria. Next, Phasmidea, it is called Secernentria, Secernentria, okay? See, the members of this Aphasmidea are, they are mostly free living, okay? Tell you freely. Whereas in case of Phasmidea, some are free living, others are parasitic. Okay, next. Amphids are of various types. Okay, here these are pore like. Okay, next. In this, phasmids are absent. Okay, Aphasmidea, the name Aphasmidea means phasmids are absent. Here the name is Phasmidea, so phasmids are present. In this, amphids are also present, they are pore like. Okay. Both are present in this case. Next, excretory glands are present and excretory canals are present in Aphasmidea. Here, excretory glands or excretory canals or both are present. Examples for the Aphasmidea or Griffiella. This is a free living. And Trichinella. It's a trichina worm or trichina worm like that. We may pronounce in any way. Okay. Next, examples for the Phasmidea are Ascaris lumbricoides. Ascaris lumbricoides. Its common name is common roundworm. Okay, common roundworm. Next, Enterobius. Pinworm. Entero. Pinworm. Encyclostoma. Hookworm. Okay, Encyclostoma. Hookworm. Next, Uchereria or Uchereria. It is filarial worm. Uchereria or Uchereria. Filarial worm. I hope you understood, friends, and this is very important, and I think it is very easy for us to remember if we read the points like this. Okay, friends, thank you.